Of tournament action in the run-up to the Commonwealth Games. Saw her reach 16. She had an entertaining match yesterday. At one time having to plead with the Indonesian crowd. She tweeted about the experience. It's a tough crowd to play in front of. A very feisty Indonesian crowd. Tweeted, I'd like to thank the crazy Indonesian crowd for laughing at my serving technique every single time. They simmered down after some pleading. We did see her on court asking them to please. Just let me get through this game. But a fun night yesterday watching all the action. The Euro All-Star team have been in action every single day this week, so probably feeling a little bit tired. Kirsty, just 21 years old, secured the silver medal for her home country, Scotland, at home for the Glasgow Commonwealth Games earlier this year in the singles. She's been one of the players to beat, and I know a lot of the Asian teams here have been pitting their best against her, so it hasn't been an easy run for Kirsty at the Axiata Cup. Comes into the Axiata Cup off a semi-final appearance at her Scottish Open, the home, a home event, losing out to Japan's Sayaka Sato in the semi-finals. Going out in the qualifiers of the French Open, the Denmark Open, the BWF World Championships. Here in Indonesia back in June for the Indonesian Open, going out in the qualifiers as well. Along with Imogen Bankia, who we will see in action later in the mixed doubles, managed a finals appearance at the Spanish Open 2014. Losing out to Gabriela Stoeva and Stefani Stoeva. The winner at the Swedish Masters this year, back in January. Plenty of tournaments that she's played this year in the run-up to the Commonwealth Games, which was the main goal for her this year, to represent her country. And all three of the Scottish players on court today for the Euro All-Stars came away medal winners in front of their home crowd. She's won the toss and elected to serve Kirsty GILMOUR, taking on Thi Trang. The umpire for this match, Shaiful Bakri of Indonesia, serving at love all. Kirsty, getting back onto the score sheet 2-8 here as Thi Trang races ahead. Thi Trang taking the edge here in the first game of the women's singles against Vietnam and the European All-Stars. Kirsty in action every single day this last week. Today being the final day, 7 days straight. Thi Trang lucky enough to get a rest yesterday as another of her compatriots took over women's singles duty. Could argue she has the fresher legs here today. Certainly looking the sprightlier in terms of the points, 11-3. Backhand across court. 13-3 now to Vu. That's wide, hitting inside the alley. 14-5. Kirsty pulling one back, 7-17. Thi Trang taking the first set here in the women's singles as Vietnam tried to take a win in this tie against a European all-star team. Thi Trang is the doubles winner in the Vietnam International Series held back in October. Made it to the semifinal stage of the Vietnam GP Open earlier in September, going out straight sets to Japan's Nozomi Okuhara. Dropped out of the qualifier, the Chinese Taipei 2014, as well as the Suffolk County Community College US Open Championships. Has had a busy year, reaching the semifinals at the Vietnam International Challenge back in March. losing out to China's Jiang Yujing. She serves here in the second game of the women's singles, a love all. Here we are at 4-5. Thi Trang here on the back foot as Kirsty GILMOUR. Six-four to Kirsty GILMOUR as she tries to take this second game. Kirsty leading here 7-5. Women's singles serving. The net getting the better of her as Vu creeps up 6-7.
Thank you.
12-14. And here we are, 18-14. The women's singles being played out on court two between the Euro All-Stars and Vietnam. Kirsty trying to edge away here, 18-14. game point here. But Vu hanging in there, 17-20 after a beautiful rally between the two girls. Great mix of shots there as Kirsty GILMOUR tries to stay in this game of the women's singles. Kirsty takes it, 21-17. We're here at a game apiece. The silver medal winning Commonwealth Games winner has had a great run here at the Axiata Cup in the league stages, kicking off the event with a win over the Philippines' Sarah Joy Barredo. Some quick two games. A tough battle against Rachna Inton on the world number 7, followed on Friday. She was up against Chen Jiayuan from Singapore. Took a loss there on Saturday. That was day 3 of the event. Day 4 on Sunday saw her take a win over the Hong Kong Open winner Tsai Tzu Ying. She's been in action every single day this week. Busy, busy girl. Kirsty GILMOUR on Monday with a loss against Malaysia's Thi Trang. And an easy walkover yesterday after the retiree of Indonesian player Linda Winnie Fenetri. But it's a busy schedule here in the league stages of the Axiata Cup, the format having changed this year. They're doing all right to have secured a game here, taking this to the rubber. She serves now at love all. 7-4 here in the deciding game. Vu with the edge. Seven, eight. She's hanging in here. Kirsty Gilmour, the higher ranked player here, world number 26. Vu, some frustration at the net. As now it is 8-all. Kirsty with a chance to go ahead. In 9-8. Vu edging away in front here in the decider, 14-10. Nice backhand. Going in for the kill there and making it 12-14. Fifteen-12 to Vu. Going wide there, 16-12. Out. Oh, the call is that it's in, so it's 17-12 now in the third game. Eighteen, 12 after that rally. Vu serving. Kirsty, sticking in here. We are at 16-19 in the decider. Vu, 2 points away from the win. The Scottish lash hanging in there. The cheers from the Vietnamese camp. They know that we are 1 point away from the win here after the error at the net from Kirsty Gilmour, 2016. Oh, and the error at the net of her own. Vu handing Kirsty the point, 17-20. Kirsty still in it. Little bit of heat on that point. 18-20. Right at her, and that is the shot that seals the deal for Vu Thi Trang, 21-8. Coming back from 17-21 in the second game, sealing it 21-18 over Kirsty Gilmour of Scotland. We are tied at one apiece in this tie between Vietnam and the Euro All-Stars. Up next, the men's doubles to be played out here on court two. You're watching the live streaming of Axiata Cup preliminary action. The league round has reached its final day. A last chance for teams to get on the score sheet, score some points to finish as high as they can on the league table. We already know who's going through to the playoff stages. Indonesia, the heavyweights, the Asian All-Stars, finishing above Thailand after their 4-0 rout this morning. Thailand are 3